Hi, in this video, you're going to learn how to create a simple chase game on Scratch. This activity is inspired by the tutorials on the Scratch website, which are a great way to get started with block-based programming. In this video, you're going to learn how to make sprites move using the arrow keys, how to add simple loops to run blocks of code multiple times, and how to add conditionals to check if something is true or false. Let's get started. When you visit the Scratch website, which is scratch.mit.edu, and you click on Create a Project, this is what you'll see, the project editor. As a quick review, the character that I have on stage is called a sprite. In Scratch, we can easily add new sprites and change the background of the stage. For example, let's choose a different sprite. I'm going to choose the octopus. This will be one of our game's components. And I'm also going to add a backdrop with the backdrop tool to set the mood for the game's space. How about the ocean? Very fitting. All right, it's time to start thinking about the game's mechanics. What are the actions that our players can take? One great way to let users move characters on stage is to use the arrow keys. Every key we press on our keyboard is considered an event by Scratch, and we can do really fun things with that. From the category events, I'm going to drag a when right arrow key pressed block into the scripts area. And when I press on the right arrow key, I want the octopus to move a few steps to the right. One really important thing to know about the Scratch stage is that it's actually a coordinate plane or grid. You may have learned already that in a coordinate plane, you have two axes, the horizontal x-axis and the vertical y-axis. To move to the right, we increase the value of x. To move to the left, we decrease the value of x. Likewise, to move up, we increase the value of y, and to move down, we decrease the value of y. So back in the editor, I can add the change x by 10 block so that when I click on the right arrow key, the octopus moves 10 steps to the right in this invisible coordinate plane. To make the octopus move to the left when the left arrow key is clicked, I'll add when left arrow key pressed, and this time I'll change the x value by minus 10. You can probably guess how I can make my sprite move up and down. When I click on the up arrow key, I want my sprite to change its y position by 10. And when I click on the down arrow key, I want my sprite to change its y position by minus 10. And awesome, I can now move it in any direction I want. By adding some simple mechanics to the game, I can let users explore the entire stage. Let's also define the game's goal. The goal of this game will be for the octopus to chase a second character, a star. I'll add this new sprite and resize it a bit to make it smaller. Because this is a chase game, I want this star to be gliding around the stage so that my octopus really has to catch it. I'm going to select my star sprite and add a glide 1 second to a random position block. If I click on this block, I can see that it does indeed glide to a random position during 1 second. However, I want it to keep gliding around the stage forever. There's a category of blocks that let you control how your code runs in Scratch, and it's called control. Specifically, I want to add what's called a forever loop, which makes any code inside it run forever in an endless loop. Let's test it out. If I click on the code blocks, the star goes on gliding forever. Finally, since I don't want players to have to click on the code to run it every time, let's add a when green flag click block at the top. If I now click on the green flag to run my program, the star starts gliding right away. It's looking great. I can move my octopus to chase the star, but if I touch it, nothing happens, and that's not very exciting. Let's go back and add a few more code blocks. There's a block in the control category called an if-then statement. This block checks to see if a condition is true. If something happens, then the program can do something else. In this if-then statement, I'm going to add a sensing block that will check to see if my sprite is touching the star. If it's true that my octopus is touching the star, I'll make the octopus say something. From the looks category, I will add a say hello for 2 seconds block, and I'll change the text to I caught you. I'll also change the 2 seconds to 1 second so this peach bubble doesn't last so long. It's looking good. The only problem is that this code will only work once. If we want our program to always be checking if our octopus is touching the star, we need to add a forever code block around all of these blocks. And there it is. One last step. I want my octopus code blocks to run as soon as I click on the green flag button. So I'll add a when green flag clicked block at the top. And we're ready to see what this looks like in full screen mode. Wow, we have a chase game that works. That's awesome. We've covered all the game design principles except for one. Rules. Players should know how this game works even before they start playing. I like to add rules directly on a project's page. I'll give my project a name and click on See Project Page from the top. This is what players will see when they visit your game. In the instructions box, I'm going to add a really simple rule. Use the arrow keys to move the octopus to chase the star. Good luck! Now I can share this project with the rest of the world and even copy the project's link to share it with friends and family. We recommend that you complete a few more tutorials on the Scratch website before moving on to the next section. Have fun programming!